Good afternoon and welcome to the Houston Consular Corps Luncheon at Houston Community College. It's great to have everyone here with us this afternoon. We're delighted to have you here today to enjoy lunch and a short program highlighted by remarks from our Chancellor, Dr. Margaret Ford Fisher. Now, it's been quite a while, in fact, since 2019 that the Consular Corps last met at HCC, so it's indeed an honor to see you all here again today. I hope you had an opportunity to walk out through our auditorium and the lobby and visit the table showcasing many HCC programs. HCC is home to 14 centers of excellence, and representatives from each of these are here to talk with you about their outstanding programs. So make sure you visit with them if you haven't done so already. At your table, you can find literature outlining each of our programs and pick up a souvenir as well. If you did not have time to visit these exhibits, please know they'll be available after lunch for a short time, and please drop by and learn more about our great HCC programs. Now, before we go any further, to get things started, let me introduce our host for today's luncheon, our Chancellor, Dr. Margaret Ford Fisher.
Thank you very much, Todd, and good afternoon, everyone. I'm so delighted to see all of you here today. Thank you so very much for joining us. It is indeed a wonderful day when we have an opportunity to meet with the distinguished members of the Houston Consular Corps. As Todd mentioned, this is the first time in 5 years that HCC has hosted the Consular Corps. Over the years, we have enjoyed wonderful partnerships with many of you, and it is my hope that today will be the first step in rekindling that relationship so we can do more together to serve our constituents. I will save my remarks until later in the program, so please allow me at this time to bring up the Vice Chair of the HCC Board of Trustees, the Honorable Lalu Davies Yumitan, to greet you. Trustee Yumitan.
Good morning. Oh, y'all can do better than that. Good morning. Buenos dias. Okay, bienvenue, and you know, je m'appelle Lalu. No, let me stop. Thank you all for being here, to the Consular Corps for honoring us with your presence. My name is Lalu Davies Yemington, and I have the honor and privilege of serving as District 4 trustee for Houston Community College. I'm here to bring you greetings and welcome on behalf of our chair, Dr. Cynthia Lenton-Gary, in her absence today, and on behalf of all of my colleagues on the Board of Trustees. With that, I will introduce a couple of my colleagues who are joining us here today. First, let me call out Trustee Charlene Ward Johnson, representing District 2. And then I have Trustee Dr. Prieta Vanderbilt Stallworth. And she represents District 9. And they, along with six others, comprise what we call sort of our HCC board family. And we're really delighted and excited to have you here. And trustees, thank you for your service to our community. And talking about community, Houston Community College really showed us a great responsibility. You know, I tell people all the time, I don't know if anyone picked up on it, I got my green, white, green going. And Honorary Consul Fullerton, at some point, y'all gonna have to create a space for Nigeria on that Consular Corps here in Houston, so I'm going to put in that shameless plug. But we're all part of the diaspora of what makes Houston great. You know, our board represents the tapestry and the diversity of Houston, and your presence here represents that as well. But we shoulder a great responsibility of educating those within our community, regardless of race, gender, income, national origin, religion, whatever disability status, wherever they come from, whatever background. We shoulder that responsibility of being the backdrop, that foundational support to provide them with a higher education opportunity. And so that's part of why we have you here today, is to help you understand better what we're doing to achieve that and to make sure that we're standing in the gap for so many within our community who might need retraining, retooling, who might need to upskill, or those who are coming from other places who want to become part of that American ecosystem, and we provide a place where they can come at an affordable tuition. I think, Jacob, you might verify, when's the last time we raised tuition? 5 years. For 5 years running, we've kept tuition low. And what does that mean? It's because we understand the importance of keeping education accessible. And affordability is a key part of that accessibility. And so that's one of the things that we prioritize. And as we work with our partners all over, it's understanding that as a board, we are committed to maintaining that access and to maintaining promoting educational opportunities for all those nationals who are living within the HCC service area. I've said this before, and I will make that argument any day. There's no better investment in higher education in this city than the Houston Community College. I want y'all to hear that again. There is no better investment in higher education in the Houston community than Houston Community College. In the short term, that education has the power of lifting people out of poverty, making their lives just a little bit better, making their dreams just a bit more attainable. In the long run, it has the profound possibility of transforming their family lives for multiple generations. It has the power of bringing someone like me here. I'm part of the diaspora because my family is the classic, what I call, chain migration family. My eldest aunt came to the U.S. in the 70s to obtain a degree. And over time, slowly but surely, we brought the next one, then the next one, then the next, all legally, by the way, I think. Let me make sure. No, okay. I think we all came legally. Attorney Fullerton has been a big part of that journey with my family life. He's an immigration attorney, and so if I say anything out of turn, just give me that left wing so I know to stop. At any rate, those who we help, they become significant contributors to our community, in addition to them getting good paying jobs. They're equipping some of those businesses, those industries that affect all of your countries, and what their aspirations are in terms of trade and global partnerships with the United States. They ultimately contribute to the betterment of our region. As I mentioned to you earlier, HCC as a board is committed. This administration is determined to do everything it can, everything required to help students where necessary. So thank you for this opportunity to bring you into our house, to meet with you, engage with you, learn a bit about what you're interested in, and share a bit about what drives us every day. Thank you and enjoy your lunch.
And thank you, Dr. Ford Fisher and Trustee Davis-Yemington. Now we're going to meet those in the room today, beginning with our honored guest from the Houston Consular Corps. Dean of the Houston Consular Corps is the Honorable Herbert Espinoza. Right there. You want to say it? Make a few more? Okay. We'll roll with it. And now we'd like to meet other members of the Houston Consular Corps. Please stand to be recognized, and let's give these international guests a warm round of applause. Thank you again for visiting HCC. All of our Consular Corps, stand. Thank you all for being here. All right. With us are also leaders from our area chambers of commerce. Let me introduce Paul Gore, director of the Asian Chamber. There's Paul. And Dr. Laura Murillo, president of and CEO of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. HCC has an exemplary partnership with the business community. Representatives of some of Houston's most outstanding companies serve on the Chancellor's Champion Business Council and provide valuable input into the college's development of program, curriculum, and student services. HCC is proud to be a pipeline to jobs at these and other area employers. Members of the CBCC, please stand so we can recognize you. We're also greatly indebted to the HCC Foundation and Foundation Board members for their tireless work they do raising funds for scholarships and student support. Several members of the Foundation Board are here today, and I'd like them to also stand and be recognized. And of course, the students. Many of them greeted you as you entered the second floor this morning. They're with part of our international student community, those that are attending HCC. Students who are here, thank you for your service. Please stand as well and be recognized. And now to greet you with brief remarks are representatives from the Chancellor's Business Advisory Board and the HCC Foundation. I'll introduce them and ask them to follow each other to the podium for succession. First, you will hear from Adrian Moeller, Vice Chair of the Chancellor's Business Advisory Council and Director of Strategy Planning and Business Development for Houston Methodist. She'll then be followed by Ed Fierro, Vice Chair of Governance for the HCCF Foundation. Ms. Moeller.
Hello. Thank you so much for having me here today to represent the members of the HCC Chancellor's Business Champions Council. So I have a wonderful honor to represent this caliber of members on the council and the breadth of the industries that are participating in this work. So the membership represents many, including manufacturing, information technology, construction, and of course, healthcare, which is my particular industry of focus. So across this council, we all know that community colleges serve as the backbone for higher education for many in Houston. We also know they provide accessible and affordable pathways to higher education and valuable workforce training. So our duty is to advise. And where connections can be made between institutions, we make those. What career growth needs might be needed to be accelerated, we work on that. And what credentials are highly needed in our workplace to help further access to and applicability of these programs, we help advise on those credentials of need. So when I was added to the Business Council, I did my due diligence internally on what HCC and community colleges mean in our particular workforce. So about 20% of our workforce, our aggregate workforce at Houston Methodist, has shown achievement of an associate's degree. We have some areas of skill set where we have as much as 60% of the people working in that particular area who have an associate's degree. Year to date at Houston Methodist, we've even hired 230 people specifically from HCC alone with training at HCC in whatever field they would have at Houston Methodist. So I found we have formalized training arrangements in areas like pharmacy and nursing. I consulted with program leads and hiring managers about the graduates. I wanted to know about who they were hiring, who they were helping to train. I talked to nursing, I talked to IT, I talked to imaging. So in doing my research as part of the council, I asked how HCC might further improve on any trainee skills or how they may add values through additional credentials. And when asked what else these graduates needed of the hiring managers to be capable in our workforce, I frankly was a little disappointed because I got nothing. I said, well, I've got to take them something. What do I take to HCC? And they said, nothing, they're great. They're great. So the graduates were skilled, professional, capable. Their answer to me was nothing, but in my work in strategy and planning for Houston Methodist, I know that's not the complete answer because the complete answer is more. Always more. So therefore, as a council member, I provide the feedback about these growth needs, about the meeting the raw need of having well-trained healthcare professionals to meet our absolute demand. And that's really been my message from day one. We just need more. So in addition to that, as I've grown with HCC, I also provide feedback to the council on our changing environment. So there's occasion where we have more growth and virtual interaction with patients. So advice that we would give as industry would be, how can graduates be trained to be comfortable with new applications which include virtual patient management? We also at Houston Methodist are reorganizing many of our internal processes to meet the demand of growth. That includes IT leadership to run without such a dependency on people. So one question that we would ask of HCC moving forward is, how can graduates support things like robotic process automation and help us in using artificial intelligence within our own workplace and healthcare? So being able to convey our industry workforce challenges and opportunities to a partner who can help us solve them through multiple programmatic avenues is so critical to us in our role as helping to serve our community. The importance of connecting community colleges to the healthcare industry cannot be overstated. It is a strategic investment in our future as a healthcare enterprise. So with that, I thank you for listening to my own perspective as a council leader of the role of the Chancellor's Business Council and how that plays in moving our industries forward with HCC support. So we all depend on relationships with educational partners like HCC to give us the skilled professionals we need and to constantly give us more. So I hope that through these few minutes today, you can hear and feel the potential for your constituents, because frankly, we want to hire them. And institutions like HCC can help make them ready to take on our challenges and get all our rewards as well. So thank you very much.
Hey, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Ed Fierro. I'm with the law firm of Bracewell, and I'm here to, I'm representing the Houston Community College Foundation. In my role on the Houston HCC Foundation Board of Directors, I serve as a vice chair of governance. The HCC Foundation is proud to partner with HCC in its mission to provide outstanding educational opportunities to students. Our role is to raise funds for HCC student success, and we do so in large part through raising funds for scholarships. Though tuition is low at HCC, many students still need financial assistance. For these, the choice to attend college or buy necessities such as medicine or food is a difficult decision to make. Scholarships help immensely. In fiscal year 2023, the HCC Foundation contributions totaled nearly $7.2 million, $6.1 million of which was provided in scholarships and grants for Houston Community College student success. Thousands of individuals and their families in our local community were transformed by the generosity of our many donors. Scholarships are available to all students that qualify, regardless of their place of origin, and applying for a scholarship is easy. It can be done online at the HCC website. While the foundation works tirelessly to raise funds for scholarships, we are blessed to live in a region that is prospering. Houstonians are among the most generous donors. There are people and organizations who want to invest in Houston's future by investing in HCC student success. I encourage you all to take this message with you, and I encourage the people you serve to invest in HCC student success through providing funding for scholarships. Our HCC Foundation staff is here and available to assist you with your philanthropic giving. HCC and the foundation stand ready to help open the door to higher education for any student seeking education as a means to a better life for themselves and their families. And on a personal note, I am a community college graduate, not of Houston, but of a different city. And I can tell you, you know, working at a law firm here in the city, my wife, me being a second generation Mexican American, and my wife being a first generation immigrant, we both have utilized community colleges as a platform to get us where we are at today. So thank you for having me, and enjoy your lunch.
I'm here to represent the Public Safety Department of Houston Community College. There, the public safety, we held the fire program, we held the law enforcement criminal justice program. We also have the EMT, Emergency Medical Technician program.
We are extended reality lab in the HCC, and we are bringing all the new technologies that that means virtual reality, augmented reality, extended reality, everything to help the students to be involved in the new technologies that the future is bringing to us. And for that reason, the HCC want to involve all the students with these new things, like create the metaverse, create augmented reality experience with filters and that kind of stuff.
AI is pervasive in the sense that AI is in everything, including robotics, because robotics is the hardware automation. And when you add intelligence to it, then you are adding the components that makes them more efficient. We are still not there yet when people think about the sci-fi movies, and you know, and we're probably not going to get to the Terminator. On the contrary, robots will just be helping us. There's a lot of cases in healthcare, education. Japan has a lot of robots that are helping care for the elderly, and that's all thanks to artificial intelligence.
We're here celebrating media, visual, and performing arts with the Consular Corps. The creative economy in Houston is one of the largest economies in this region. We employ about a quarter of participants in the creative economy in Houston, but the wages for the creative economy are, we have about half of that here in Houston for the overall state. So really excited to get our students out into the field.
Well, all right, I hope everyone has enjoyed your lunch. We're gonna get our program resumed very shortly. It is my delight now to introduce you once again to Dr. Margaret Ford Fisher, our chancellor here at Houston Community College. Now, a full bio for Dr. Ford Fisher is in your packet. If you've not met Dr. Ford Fisher, allow me to mention a few highlights in her illustrious career. She began her tenure here at HCC nearly 40 years ago and has held most every significant position in academics and executive leadership at the college for those years. For 21 years, she served as president of HCC's Northeast College and followed that as founding president of our online college. Under her leadership, HCC Northeast College grew and thrived with an enrollment of 14,000 students, and on the online college grew to include more than 60 fully online degrees and 70 hybrid courses, with an enrollment of more than 62,000 students. In addition to being one of the largest online colleges in America, Newsweek magazine has listed HCC Online as one of the nation's top online programs since 2022 and 2023. Yep. She's an acclaimed educational leader and published author. She was named Chancellor of Houston Community College in January of this year, and we're proud to have her. Dr. Ford Fisher.
Well, thank you again, Mr. Duplantis. And again, good afternoon, everyone. I hope you enjoyed your lunch. Once again, I want to welcome the many friends and partners of HCC who are in the room today. To the honorable members of the Consular Corps of Houston, thank you. Our wonderful partners from the Chancellor's Business Champions Council, thank you. Chamber presidents who are here, thank you. And welcome to you all. I am most grateful to our HCC Board of Trustees for their unwavering support. Thank you, Vice Chair, Trustee Lalu Davis-Yumaton, Trustee Dr. Preta Vanderbilt-Stallworth, Trustee Charlene Ward-Johnson, and to all of the other board members for the Houston Community College, thank you very much for your leadership, and thank you for being here this afternoon. Let me also say thank you to our international students who are here today. HCC has one of the largest international student populations in the country. These students are not only enriching their lives through their educational pursuits at HCC, but also the lives of all who get to experience what they, our international students, have to offer to HCC and to the community at large with their knowledge, their skills, and their cultural richness. I'd like to thank them as well as the members of the Chancellor's Executive Council who are here, the deans who displayed the magnificent exhibits, and the president of the online college and his team who will be conducting a tour of the online college on the ninth floor. Houston Community College is most grateful for your presence, and we highly value our partnership and collaboration. With more than 90 nations represented, Houston is home to the third largest consular corps in the United States. HCC values the vital role the consulates play in making Houston the global city it is today. As you work to develop economic, commercial, scientific, and cultural relations, consider HCC a collaborative partner and resource to you and to those whom you serve. Houston has been called one of the most diverse cities in the United States, and it is. According to the latest U.S. Census, an estimated 145 languages are spoken in Houston's homes, and 48% of Houston residents speak a language other than English at home. Truly, the world is at our doorstep. HCC says, welcome. Our doors are open to all who desire to change their lives through education. Our goal, similar to yours, is to improve the lives of all who call Houston home by working closely together with you. Nelson Mandela once said, and I quote, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world, end quote. And we here at Houston Community College believe that. If the world has truly come to our doorstep, then it has come to the right place. There is no better place to be at this moment than Houston. Houston's regional gross domestic product is $490 billion. 26 Fortune 500 companies are headquartered in Houston. More than 12,000 Houston area companies are engaged in global commerce. The Houston region is home to 618 chemical manufacturers that provide 44% of the national capacity. Think about it. That's almost half of a nation's refining products coming through Houston. And the Houston Metro is the top exporting metro in the nation with $175.5 billion in exports last year. We are proud of our world-famous Texas Medical Center, the world's largest medical complex and home to HCC's Coleman College for the Health Sciences. In all, more than 376,000 are employed there as healthcare professionals. We can do more. Also, in the area are 9,100 tech-related firms that employ more than 230,000 tech workers. More than 228,000 whole manufacturing jobs, and another 220,000 are hired in the construction industry. The data suggests that Houston and its surrounding area is still the land of opportunity. Unfortunately, however, there are nearly a million residents who do not enjoy this prosperity because they lack the skills and training needed to secure a meaningful job. And many cannot obtain that training because of their economic reality. In fact, 45% of our students come from households with an annual income of less than $24,000. 937,000 adults, 61% in our service area, over age 25, do not hold a college degree. And from that group of adults, 300,000 have not graduated from high school. Many have come only recently to the United States, and HCC is working throughout our communities to make a difference for those who need us the most. For 53 years, Houston Community College has served the educational needs of the greater Houston region through courses that transfer to four-year colleges and universities. We provide workforce training, both degrees and certificates, credit and non-credit, which leads students directly to meaningful, well-paying jobs. We are known as Houston's Community College because of this local focus on preparing our students for real-world jobs right here at home. We have done an outstanding job fulfilling our mission. Today, HCC is one of the largest community colleges in the nation, serving more than 85,000 students annually. Students who will fill the pipeline for in-demand jobs that businesses and industries need. Among our student population are more than 3,400 international students from all across the globe. The top five nations represented in our student population are Vietnam, Nigeria, India, China, and Mexico. We are excited about our efforts and welcome all of our students from around the globe. Among two-year institutions, HCC is number one in the nation in awarding associate degrees to international students. We are number one in the state in awarding associate degrees to Asian students. Last year, HCC was a recipient of the Excellencia in Education Award, demonstrating exceptional support and success in serving Latino and other underserved student populations. And yes, we are proud, very proud, of our efforts and of our students. So, what makes us the college of choice for so many students? First of all, because HCC students can receive a real-world education through completion of more than 191 workforce programs and a growing number of apprenticeships, which lead to permanent jobs. We are continually expanding our programs and course offerings to serve the needs of our community. Earlier this month, our accrediting agency, the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools, Commission on Colleges, approved HCC to begin offering four-year degrees in addition to our two-year associate degrees. Our first two baccalaureate degrees are Artificial Intelligence and Robotics and Healthcare Management. Jobs in these fields are in high demand and skilled workers in short supply. As HCC offers these newly approved programs to our students, we will help fill in-demand jobs. We will provide more. Additional four-year degree programs will soon follow. You can count on HCC to deliver new and cutting-edge programs that provide the training for jobs that will move Houston and our students forward in the days and years to come. We are the college of choice in part because HCC has one of the lowest tuition rates in the nation. Financial aid is also readily available for our students. Students also choose HCC because of our high-touch philosophy. Our classes are small, our faculty members are outstanding, and we provide a wide array of services to help students gain access to and through their educational journey so they can graduate with a credential of value and be ready for the future. I mention these details because Houston Community College has been a long-time effective partner in changing lives through education. HCC is a partner you can count on, a partner to whom you can assuredly refer others who seek the help they need to get ahead in life. Just as Ruben Ortega, a native of Mexico, Mr. Ortega migrated to the United States and pursued studies at HCC as a culinary student in 1991. He sacrificed his own career to assist his brother Hugo in building successful restaurants and a legacy for cuisine in Houston. Ruben received the first place honor at the Texas Culinary Federation statewide cooking contest in 1993. He was named Pastry Chef of the Year at the 2003 Houston Culinary Awards and Pastry Chef of the Year in 2019 by Culture Map Houston. This is one of many success stories from HCC's international student population. HCC also has a history of successful partnerships in the international community. Since the late 1990s, HCC has been engaged in international partnerships with universities, study abroad initiatives, businesses, and governments. Some of our educational collaborations have been in Qatar, Saigon, and Pueblo, Mexico. These engagements have benefited students, faculty, and the entire college. Our engagements have also benefited our partnering countries. We are presently partnering with the Consulate General of Mexico to provide educational programs to Mexican nationals living here in Houston, an agreement which can serve as a model for partnerships with other nations. HCC's online college offers even more opportunities to work with other nations. Presently, the HCC online college offers more than 60 fully online courses and another 70 that are hybrid. These programs are available in English to students around the world. Houston Community College has a strong relationship with the esteemed Consular Corps of Houston. We value this relationship and all that it affords those who seek to positively advance, both educationally and economically. With Houston's international population growing, it is our desire to continue our work with you to expand educational opportunities. Opportunities that will develop workforce skills, provide access to meaningful jobs, and elevate the lives of those within our diverse communities, at home and abroad. So this is a call to action. Let us work together to extend opportunities to our international community, those in the Houston area, as well as those abroad. There is no better investment that we can make to raise the aspirations and achievements of our residents than an investment in education. Brad Henry, the former governor of Oklahoma, said it well, and I quote, "No other investment yields as great a return as an investment in education. An educated workforce is the foundation of every community and the future of every economy," end quote. And as former United States President Barack Obama said, and I quote, "Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we have been waiting for. We are the change that we seek," end quote. And well noted, well honored, and well recognized, Mahatma Gandhi of India wrote, and I quote, "The future depends on what we do in the present. And you must be the change you wish to see in the world," end quote. So it is up to us, and I know we can do it as we think and act together. The deep sense of partnership between HCC and all of you will help us meet any challenge we might encounter. We have every reason to believe we will succeed because our cause is right and our strong partnership is with you. So thank you, each of you, for your commitment, your partnership, and your unrelenting passion for those whom we also serve. The future is bright, thanks to you. I hope you will take time to browse the exhibit tables in the foyer. Our deans and presidents will be there to share information with you about what they offer. These exhibits showcase our 14 centers of excellence and the outstanding programs offered here at HCC. Please also take time to tour our new online college facilities located on the 9th floor. Team members will be available at the elevators to escort you there to see what we provide and what we can deliver in partnership with you. I hope you see the possibilities of partnering with us now and in the days to come. Thank you all so very much.
Thank you, Dr. Ford Fisher. It is now my privilege to introduce the Honorable Herbert Espinoza. He is the Dean of the Consular Corps of Houston and Consul General of Costa Rica for a presentation by the Chancellor. Mr. Espinoza is a career diplomat with 20 years of experience in the Costa Rican Foreign Service. He has a law degree from the law faculty of the University of Costa Rica, the most prestigious law faculty in his country, and a master's degree in foreign affairs and international law from the Complutense University in Madrid. He was Consul General of Costa Rica in Austria, alternate representative of Costa Rica to the international organizations in Vienna, head of the International Corporation of Costa Rica with the European Union, political counselor at the Embassy of Costa Rica in Guatemala, and officer at the Human Rights and Americas Department of the Costa Rican Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Been around a lot. Mr. Espinoza worked in the private sector as a legal consultant at KPMG Costa Rica before joining the Costa Rican Foreign Service. He was appointed Consul General of Costa Rica in Houston in 2018 and was designated as the Dean of the Consular Corps in March of 2023. Mr. Espinoza will complete his tour of duty in Houston at the end of July, this next month, and be appointed as head of the consular department at the Costa Rican Ministry of Foreign Affairs in San Jose. Get to move again, huh? He is married and has two sons.
I'm so very, very honored that you, Consul General Espinoza, has joined us today with other members of the Consular Corps. We appreciate your support, all of the work that you do, and we look forward to continuing our connection with you as you depart Houston. We thank you so much for all of your contributions. And in appreciation, we wanted to provide you with this certificate to the Honorable Herbert Espinoza, Consul General of Costa Rica in Houston, for his service as Dean of the Consular Corps of Houston, presented June the 25th, 2024, Margaret Ford Fisher, Chancellor, Cynthia Linton Gary, PhD, Chair, Board of Trustees. I would like for our board members to please join us in a photo, please. Thank you so
Thank
very,
you.
Very much.
Thank you
so
much.
This is for you as well.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Ford Fisher, for this. I really appreciate it. It's as it was said, I'm finishing my tour of duty in July, and this will go literally with me to Costa Rica because most of our things are already on their way. So this will be with me at the plane. And no, thank you very much. It's to the HCC for opening the doors for us to the Consular Corps. During my 6 years in Houston, wonderful years for my family and for me. It's one of my focus has been education. I am a strong believer in as Dr. Ford Fisher said, education and the all the wonderful people she mentioned, it's education is the way for our societies to improve, to grow, and cooperation in education between countries, U.S. Institutions, Costa Rican institutions, and from all the other countries we represent, it's really very important for all of us. And as a dean also has been one of my focus, and I am very grateful that you opened your house to us, Dr. Ford Fisher. Thank you very much for that. And I'll be not far from here, and Dr. Ford Fisher is an expert in online education, which opened a lot of possibilities for our people here in Houston, in the U.S., and in back in our countries. In countries like mine, the opportunities that community colleges offer are not very well known, and I already promised Dr. Ford Fisher that I will take care that it's there's more information about that, and taking advantage of online tools, we will plan activities and events for with that purpose. So thank you all. I really appreciate this. I will keep it close to me, and it will be part of the great memories and the great things that I have lived here in Houston. Thank you very much.
Well, this concludes this portion of our luncheon today. Before you go, we invite you to take a tour of our new online college facilities on the 9th floor. In the next 5 minutes, they'll be leaving over to the right of the room where you see the sign for the online tour. You'll be guided by Dr. Jerome Drain, Anna Goh, and Brett Haddock of the online college. And finally, the exhibits in the foyer will be staffed for a little bit longer, so please feel free to drop by, pick up some literature, and meet with our deans and program leaders out there. Thank you all for coming. Have a great day.